In the second unit, epidemiology, next point is epidemiology of tuberculosis. Tuberculosis is a serious and most important disease because nearly 25% of population in each and every country has this disease. They face the problems related with this disease. Hence, the World Tuberculosis Day is defined, and for the awareness of tuberculosis, on the 24th March, the World Tuberculosis Day, that is Awareness Day, is celebrated, and various programs are organized and continuously they are worked out. This disease is basically lung disease. Its causative agent is Mycobacterium tuberculosis. This bacteria can appear either gram-negative or gram-positive bacteria of the genus of Actinobacteria. Apart from the lungs, these bacteria can attack and spread to other parts of the body, including the brain, spine, kidney, etc. Hence, called as a multisystemic disease. Tuberculosis is potentially serious infectious disease. Means, this disease is spread from one person to another person, which are in close contact, and hence this disease is very harmful and affecting the total mankind, total population. The epidemiology of tuberculosis is studied by the medical world. In the 20th century, TB was leading cause of death in United States. After the discovery of TB vaccination, there are many cases which have been cured with antibiotics. As TB is a multisystemic disease, the antibiotics may take months together or even longer period to completely cure this infectious disease. This disease is a longer and dependent upon immune system disease. Hence, its spread is also important. Tuberculosis, referred as TB, it is contagious disease, but it cannot be spread easily as bacteria cannot survive on a exposed external surfaces. Means, this disease spreads through the nasal drops, droplets, but they are not surviving in a external environment for longer time, hence cannot infect after the few time period or the after the distance. Any person who is in constant contact with an infected person has a high risk of contracting the disease. Therefore, co-workers, close family members, friends, and anybody who is proximity to the infected person is at higher risk of being infected. Means, the nearer persons, right from health workers up to the family members, are at the risk. There are the two types of tuberculosis on the basis of the infectious stages or the symptom stages. First one is latent tuberculosis. Second one is active tuberculosis. Latent tuberculosis means, the its name suggests, latent tuberculosis doesn't make the person sick or contagious. Means, that person is not showing any symptom of sickness. as well as it cannot spread a disease from the self to another person. Though the causative microbe is present within them, the infected individual does not show any symptom. This is because their immune system stops the microbes from spreading but doesn't completely kill it. This creates a window of opportunity for microbes to become active one day. Means when the patient's immune system is on the right way, on a optimal level, this disease not shows any symptom, but it remains alive. These microbes are not killed inside the body by the immune system. That immune system of such a patient not sufficient strong to kill it, but only it can prevent the spread, and hence they become active one day. Means when immune system is depressed or weakness is developed, at that time such a latent tuberculosis is converted into active tuberculosis. Second type is active tuberculosis. Active TB can make the infected person sick and contagious. Most cases of adult TB are activated from the old latent TB infections. Means the latent tuberculosis have no any problem, no any symptom or sickness, but it is important it should be cured with medicine, otherwise it is converted into active tuberculosis. The another types of tuberculosis on the location of the bacterial infection, that are the two types, pulmonary tuberculosis and extra pulmonary tuberculosis. The pulmonary tuberculosis shows these three types: primary tuberculosis pneumonia. Associated symptoms include coughing and high fever. It can also rise in patients with HIV AIDS. Second one, miliary tuberculosis. In this case, this form of TB named so because of infective distinctive pattern seen on a chest radiograph, where many small spots distributed throughout the lung fields bearing an appearance similar to millet seeds. Means in a radiograph the appearance is like a millet, means a dotted condition. This infection can eventually spread to extra pulmonary organs such as spleen, liver and kidney. Such a case is called as miliary tuberculosis. Next one is latent tuberculosis infection. This infection is mainly seen in those patients having bacteria within their body but does not display any of the symptoms of the disease. This infection is primarily detected through the tuberculin test only because the symptoms are not present. All these three types are related with the tuberculosis of only lungs, hence called pulmonary tuberculosis. Next one is extra pulmonary tuberculosis. In immunocompromised patients, means the patients whose immune system is depressed due to some reasons, weakness, poverty, AIDS, any. At that time, the original pulmonary tuberculosis spreads in the body in various organs. That is, tuberculosis meningitis, means in a brain covers meningitis, that meninges gets tuberculosis infection. Next one is osteal tuberculosis, that is bone tuberculosis. Lymph node tuberculosis, means lymph nodes get infected by the bacteria. Renal tuberculosis, means renal area getting infection of TB. Adrenal tuberculosis, that adrenal gland has the TB infection. In this way, bacteria from the lungs spread into different organs, and this extra pulmonary tuberculosis is developed. The signs and symptoms of TB are as follows. Out of that, many, more than 5 symptoms are compared with common sickness symptom, and hence the TB patients are not getting a proper treatment. First one, fever, chill, chest pain, weight loss, night sweats, breathlessness, loss of appetite, excessive fatigue, coughing up mucus streaked with blood, a persistent cough that lasts over 20 to 25 days. These all symptoms, the duration is most important. Many times the few days disease can be cured automatically, and this is a one concept, but it may lead into TB. It may be first stage of TB, and it must be checked, it must be medicated, then and then only TB patients can be minimized. Causes of tuberculosis. The infants and senile persons, means old and weak persons, are at higher risk of catching TB infections. Individuals with weak immune system are at increased risk. Means the immune system is weak, then automatically TB infection is possible. Metabolic diseases such as diabetes can also increase the risk of contracting TB. Tuberculosis is a contagious airborne disease which can be acquired from close contact with an infected person. This infected person may be a family member, may be an office member, may come in contact with any health center or any hospital, and infection is possible. The Mycobacterium tuberculosis is one of the leading causes of this dreadful infectious disease. It is pathogenic bacterial species and mainly comprises four other types of TB causing bacteria, namely Mycobacterium bovis, Mycobacterium canetti, Mycobacterium microti, Mycobacterium africanum. These are different strains, and they can cause the tuberculosis. Diagnosis of tuberculosis. Apart from the all physical tests, other tests are available to diagnose the patient, the infectious bacteria. These tests include certain body fluid tests, blood and sputum test, skin test, chest x-rays, etc. Blood test. In this procedure, blood samples are collected and are tested in laboratories for a presence or absence of TB germs in blood cells. Skin test. It is most common type of test. In this procedure, a small sample of tuberculin. Tuberculin is a purified protein. It is injected under the patient's skin. If skin around the site of injection gets swollen more than 5 mm area, then it is a clear indication of TB infection. The treatment of tuberculosis. Drug treatment is one of the most efficient way to treat this infectious disease. For patients with latent TB infection, doctors generally prescribe an antibiotic called ionized for preventing the latent infection from becoming active. The active TB cases will be deadly if left untreated. The procedure involved is taking combination of medicines like ethambutol, INH, priftine and parazinamide for a term of 3 months, followed by a mixture of INH and parazinamide for 12 months. Treatment is available, but number of patients are increasing. The risks and complications. Tuberculosis infection is extremely common. An estimated 1/4 of the world's population is infected. People with TB infection risk developing TB disease, and this risk depends upon multiple factors, the most important being the state of their immune system. Acute and subacute complications of TB disease are attributable to structural damage or vascular compromise caused by this bacteria, as well as metabolic abnormalities and host inflammatory responses. TB related sepsis is a life threatening acute complication for which current diagnostic and management approaches are likely inadequate. These risks are there. Preventing the tuberculosis. World Health Organization gives guidelines. WHO advises and guides the TB vaccine development activities of the global research community through scientific census building, guidance on vaccine evolution and assessment of evidence base for policy recommendations. WHO supports the countries to prevent TB infections through guidance and implementation of infection prevention and control measures. These measures are critical in situations where the risk of TB transmission is high, such as healthcare facilities, congregate settings, and TB affected households. WHO also promotes preventive action through early screening and treatment for active TB by addressing comorbidities and health risks, as well as social determinants of the disease, and by promoting access to universal health care. Preventive measures of tuberculosis are as follows. Isolation from workplace, schools, colleges and areas with crowds. Covering one's mouth and nose while coughing or sneezing. Adequate and careful disposal of tissues, usually burning or disposal in sealed plastic bags, is recommended. Sharing beds and rooms with uninfected person while sleeping should be avoided. The tuberculosis prevention is most important and best understood with help of this diagram. Personal hygiene is most important, immunization is also important, and healthy lifestyle and healthy environment should be provided, and it is sufficient for prevention. Cigarette smoking causes tuberculosis. The tobacco has most vital role in tuberculosis. Tuberculosis and tobacco smoking substantially increases the risk of TB and death from the TB. More than 20% of global TB incidences may be attributed to smoking. Controlling the tobacco epidemic will help control the TB. Smoking is a risk factor for TB, independent of alcohol use and other socioeconomic risk factors. Smoking increases the risk of TB disease by more than 2.5 times. It is most important. The action plans are most important. There are patient-oriented actions. They are called as 5 A's and 5 R's. The five A's are: ask the TB patient about their tobacco use, and say for minimizing, advise them to quit, assess their willingness to attempt to quit, assist in their attempt to quit, and last one is arrange, follow up for them. All these five A are important in the prevention of TB. And five R, the first R, relevance, risk, rewards, red blocks and repetition. Relevance means ensure TB patient know their treatment will be more effective if they quit smoking. Risk, point out all the risk of continuing to smoke including the risk of TB relapses. Rewards, educate the TB patient about the many other benefits of quitting the smoking. Roadblocks, ask the patient to identify obstacles to quitting the smoking. Repetition, continue to encourage the TB patient to quit the smoking. These 5A and 5R are most important and must be followed by all students for their society also. And after that, we can protect our lungs, and finally, after the lungs, total health, total body is must be prevented and protected.